For as much as Anthony Simonet and Anya Payton Smith have consented together to enter the holy rite of marriage before God and these witnesses, and have given and received a ring in token and pledge of their love to and faith in each other, and have declared the same by the joining of their right hands, I declare by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel that you are husband and wife, according to the ordinance of God and the law of Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ. Mr. Simonet, you may at this time salute your bride. I want you all to simultaneously repeat this and share it, but looking at each other with the deepest meaning. I'll go slow enough so you can hear what I'm saying, but I want you to share these words with each other. It's a vow of commitment. Entreat me not to leave thee, or return from following after thee. For whether thou goest, I go. And where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God, my God. Where thou diest, will I die, and there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also, if aught but death part thee and me. Wonderful. Within the ceremony, within the relationship, within this marriage ceremony, there is a covenant that is shared between the bride and the groom. Oftentimes it may be a unity candle. The couple today have elected to share a sand covenant, and if you will escort your bride to share this sand covenant, and I believe that there is a wonderful soloist that is preparing to sing. Just a moment, I would like to share just before our soloist singing and our couple engage. I like to share the significance of this covenant. It's often that others may use salt. As I said, they may use a unity candle. And in this case, it's a sand covenant. But the whole covenant is designed to show the relationship, the unbreakable relationship between the husband and the wife. Now, when they share together and pour the sand into the vase, even in our counseling sessions, I share with them that if you are able, the only way that you can break this covenant, if you are able to go in there and take out your sand. The scripture says that two become one. And when the sand is poured in, it's coming from different jars, but into one vase. And so they two now become one. But the only way, Anthony and Anya, that you can back out of it, and that's why I'm sharing it before they do it, the only way you can back out of it is you can go in and pull out every single grain that you put in. For a marriage and relationship, it's not 50-50, but it's 100-100. What you put in is what you get out of it. Thank you. We ought to humble ourselves before the Lord. Kneeling is still appropriate when we talk about a sovereign and supreme God. And I want you to focus in with me as I lay my hands on both of them and asking God's blessing upon their life. Father, it's me. I come with thanksgiving once again. I say thank you for everything, and I thank you for all things. We thank you, God. Before we ask you of anything, we thank you for your glory. We thank you for this gift today. We thank you for your grace. Now, God, we simply ask that you will bless them immensely. You will shower upon them. You will cause their home to be happy and blessed. Anyone that walk into their home, they walk in with peace and in the right spirit. Let your blood cover them, protect them, keep them. Father, in all of their endeavorments and everything, God, that they desire to do, cause it to be blessed as they acknowledge you in all of their ways. We thank you, and we give your name all of the praise and glory and honor. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Take this moment and turn and face this great audience. It is with love and honor that I present to you today, Mr. and Mrs. Anthony Smith.